First of all, welcome Dave Stevens and Sorba Thomas to Coach's Corner. This is the second one that we've had with a guest from the BW Pace Academy. The first two, Jamal and Femi, were very good. I've got to be honest, set a standard. We felt that you two could be better. Your banter's better, probably better looking. So hopefully, fingers crossed. Technically, yes and no, but you could probably pass Jammer off with Steve-O, couldn't you? But it's more Sorba. Sorba, probably you have honestly grown so much hair
over keep that hat on,
off period.
Let's have a look.
So the first question, guys, I'm going to put it to Sorba initially, yeah? It would be your role model growing up.
Well, my role model growing up was a man called Ray Jerome. So he was my first ever football coach. And it was one of the ones who taught me like a lot of discipline when I was younger. Obviously, young boy coming from like a rough neighbourhood. So obviously, he kept me level pad. And I'd say he was like a second father figure to me. So it helped me a lot, obviously, outside of football. So obviously, my dad's like constantly working. He'd be there to talk to, help me from my schoolwork and stuff like that. So my role model was Ray Jerome.
Do you still talk to him now, Sorbs?
Yeah, still talk to him now. Obviously, now he works at West Ham now.
Ah, brilliant. Well, so he's a coach still?
Yeah.
And so was that a Sunday team or?
What's that, sir?
Was it a Sunday team or just a general coach that you used to do bits with?
It was a Sunday team. Oh. Yeah. So for at 7-a-side and then obviously the start of 11-a-side. And obviously he got me in my move when I got scouted for West Ham when I was younger. And obviously he's been there ever since, even now.
Superb, mate. Brilliant. Cam's yours?
I had quite a few. But I guess growing up, wanted to be a footballer. All you ever wanted was probably Cafu, because I was a right back, looked up to him. I think he was probably the first of his sort of kind that could do both sides, where fullback in before that had sort of been defend, stay in your bolt, old defend. Then you've got Cafu and Carlos on the other side, who sort of started a new brand of sort of fullback play, getting on, attacking. And for myself as a right back coming through, I was always tried modelling myself on him. When I played, I always imagined I'd play like him, going and getting on and crossing the ball and getting in the other team's box. So it was definitely looking up to Cafu. But also, I had Rob Jones. I spoke with Rob Jones before in one of the podcasts. I went to Wembley, I had a tour of Wembley when I was a youngster. I sat in front of the two shirt and I was like, I want to be Rob Jones. I'm not sure many people grow up to want to be Rob Jones, but that was me.
The one who was at Doncaster?
He was, yeah. Further down. No, he wasn't. No. Liverpool, for his whole career, never scored a goal for Liverpool. Played probably 3 French times before. He was.
You support Liverpool, Cameron?
Yes.
But
yeah, so mixed between Rob Jones and Cafu, looking up to him for probably different reasons. But yeah.
That's some spectrum, though. No disrespect to Rob Jones. I would take Rob Jones's career, I'd cut me right arm off. Don't get me wrong. There's Rob Jones, then there's Cafu.
Yeah.
There's some spectrum, isn't it?
But Cafu for his qualities, Rob Jones because he played for the club that I loved.
Fair. Steve-O, yourself, who's your role model, mate?
Probably growing up, I used to play like striker. So I used to like Ronaldo, R9. And he just excited everyone, didn't he, around those times. Like his career got cut short way too early. Probably because of injury or I don't know.
He done 3 ACLs, didn't he?
Yeah.
He had 3 ACLs. So I think, and he still played Brazilian, is it Corinthians? He still played for Corinthians when he went back there after 3 ACLs or so. When they talk about Ronaldo, for me, there's only one Ronaldo. R9 is Ronaldo.
He just done things that you won't see again. And I don't know, he just excited me so much when I was young. I wanted to be him, everything. And now I'm a centre-half.
And you do, to be fair though, Steve, you do some skills. You know when you do that bit with your foot?
Yeah. The little...
Oh, brilliant. I remember him doing that against all the centre-halves in the Italian league. Yeah. You've modelled your game on him. I have to agree. He is one role model. Cafu as well. Superb. Rob Jones, question mark. But I think he's superb. I'm going to go along the lines of Sorba. I had a coach, Dermot Drummy, was my first coach at Arsenal. And like you, Sorbs, took me in there initially, had 4 or 5 years with him. Obviously, you go through the levels with him as a coach. And then when I got the job at Bournemouth, he rang me and just gave me advice. And I would talk to him when I went to Tottenham. I left Arsenal to go to Tottenham and I'd still have conversations with him. Then I went to Swindon and he'll just touch base with you every step along the way. And then for me, yeah, I think he was a role model. You can all say your parents, of course, your mum, your dad are massive role models. But in the sport you love, you fundamentally hover towards someone that's involved in it. So I'd say Dermot Drummy, mate. So I'm like Sorba. I had a figure that looked after me in terms of that, followed me through my career. So yeah, he was a top, top man. Adore him immensely, immensely. On to the next question then.
Yeah,
it's a good question. I have to say, this question is your Bournemouth five-a-side. And you can't pick yourself. And me and Cameron can't pick either one of you. And I'll be honest with you, one of you are getting in. And I'm not going to say who. Starts in S and ends in TiVo. But... Sorba, what's your thoughts? What's your... Okay, so what takes it? So on a, it's not an 11-side, Sorba. So don't get it mistaken with 11-side. You need leaders. You need... It's five-a-side.
You need go all striker.
Listen, you do what you got to do. But you just told me you're a striker. I would have the luxury. I've got Gary Doherty with us, centre-half striker.
Gary.
Dion Dublin, centre-half striker.
Chris Sutton.
Chrissy Sutton. Sorba, what's your... this will be interesting. I think we'll all have one player exactly the same. Sorba, what's your team, mate?
I got Ashmore in goal.
Ashmore, yeah.
Then I got Femi.
Okay.
And obviously, then I got Maka, Kieran and Kane. And then Cavs up top.
Sorry. One second. Your five-a-side team, so you've got Ashmore.
In goal.
Ashmore. Femi.
Oh!
Kieran. Kane and Cavs.
He's got a sub. He's got a sub.
So I'm going to give you my five-a-side team. We're going to win everything because I'm going to play six players. Fantastic. I'm so glad. Sorba, you are the best. Seriously, I love you to bits. You are so dumb.
There's six, isn't it?
There is
one sub.
No, pick your five-a-side team.
Take one out.
You know what? Sorry, Fem, but I'm going to take Fem out.
Oh.
Ball players.
I was going to say, you can't expect them to kick it 50 yards in a 5-0 game, surely.
No, I thought no one could get past him, so I just put him there.
Listen, as a centre-half, he is very good, isn't he? So you go on and everyone else attack, you just defend. That's a fair point. So you've gone Ashmore.
Yeah. Kieran.
Kieran.
Maka.
Maka.
Kane.
Kane.
Cabs.
Cabs. Nice. Decent team.
Good. Yeah. I'm close to that. I've got to be honest with you.
What's your team, Cabs?
I've got Ashmore in goal.
Yeah.
Okay, I've gone cunning enough. I've got no striker. I love the strikers. I love you all strikers, but I've not got a striker in there.
Weirdo.
Yeah, no, but
you're weird. Big on Rob Jones. Rob Jones up top.
Jonesy, yeah. Ashmore, Kane, gone Champs, gone Kieran, and I've gone Maka. Okay, my reasons. I've got Champs and Kane that can do both. Well, Kane can do both going forward and going backwards. Champs to organise the back line. And then you've got Kieran and Maka just to cause havoc. You watch them in the five aside, they just... Kieran could have a ball by himself and just run the show. But then you've got Maka in five aside. He's unbelievable. I challenge that team. That ain't getting beat by no one.
But you ain't beating anyone.
No, we'd score.
You'd be like 0-0. Well done. 0-0. Move on. And then 0-0. Move on.
Kieran, Maka and Kane.
You've gone two centre-half. You've gone two defenders in a 5-0 team.
Yeah.
Sorba, talk to you, my boy.
Nah. Someone needs to take Cam back to party. I'll play a proper 5-a-side game.
I'll take a 1-0.
But that's all you'll be getting. 5-0's exciting. 5-0's exciting, yeah.
Kieran and Maka and Kane. Them three. Enough said.
Well, you're telling me there's not a player that does more than that in a 5-0 game. When we play 5-a-side, 7-a-side.
No, I like my team is can do everything. Goals, defend.
Steve, don't do that. Steve, don't do that. Don't go as if to give him the acknowledgement. Yeah. No, Steve, right, I don't do that. Who you got then, Steve? Who you got? Jamal, Femi, Kane.
I'll go Grant in goal because we do smaller goals in a five side, wouldn't we? So it'll be he's like a cat, isn't he?
Yeah, okay. Fair shout, yeah.
Yeah. I'll go Femi.
Yeah.
Just boss everything at the back.
Yeah.
And then I'll go Kiers, Piero, Shebu, and Maka.
Brilliant. Could you name your five side team again, please, Steve?
Well, how many of them?
That's six, mate.
I'll probably take Maka out. So I'll take Piero, Kiers, and Femi out on field.
Yeah. Good.
Because yeah, Shebu's just he's frightening. Like I said to him so many times, I can't read that.
Well, that says Shebu, Steve-O. I'm not trying to nick. How good is he?
He's nodding.
You didn't have him in your team.
Do you know where it is? He's there somewhere in spirit.
Your boys. Yeah, you're my boy, Blue. And you've left him out.
Playing, being defender.
But he's not really a forward player, though.
Playing against him or Cabs. I'd rather play against Cabs all day.
Listen,
no disrespect to Cabs. Like, he's probably still live.
You can't cane Cabs on live TV sort of thing. Yeah, no disrespect. I'm sorry, mate.
It still twists me up, but I'm saying Shebu, he's just frightening. I think so.
So yours is Smudger, Femi, Kieran, Piero, Shebu.
Yeah.
Not bad, that. I have to say, I'm not far. I've gone Ashmore. I just think, you know, when you say a cat, he still gets down in them little corners. He's a presence. He probably laid down. You can't get it in the goal if you lay down. I've gone Femi. I'm saying I want an offensive free. Femi, you just got to defend for me, mate. Yeah. I want Ashmore bypassing him with the ball. I can't even give him the ball. Literally, throw it past Femi.
Why don't you want to give him the ball?
Because he has a fight with it, Steve-O. We all know that. Come on. I love Femi. I had a conversation with Femi last night. 20 minutes. He knows I'm only messing. I absolutely adore Femi. I'm going to go our Maverick. We've all gone Kieran Murta. We've all gone Kieran. We know what he does. The kiddie can unlock a door. I've gone Shebu and Marshy.
Forgot about him.
Yeah. Oh. Imagine we had Marshy. Yeah, Marshy. I just think I like to excite my teams. My team does your team 5-0 camps.
No chance. You're missing out Maka, mate. In five aside, Maka.
Maka's good. Maka's good. Maka's very good. But
all day long in my team.
Okay, let's be honest. Would you have Steve or Sorba in that five-a-side team if you had an opportunity?
Yeah.
Who? Both.
Don't. Neither.
No, I'd go one. No bank. I'd go Sorba.
Thank you.
Look at Steve's face.
Yeah, I'd probably.
Steve, I'd have you as well because we can play. We can move the ball. Do you know what I mean? We pass.
I'd have you as a forward, Steve.
Cheers.
R9.
Yeah. R9. You got the same hair. Remember when he had that hair, that little thing? You should grow it. Did a little top head. Don't do that, Steve. The light's bouncing off your forehead, mate. Move on then. Good 5-0 team, though. Good 5-0 teams there. Got to get a tournament going on when we get back to the ground.
I'll be involved.
So, yeah, Sorba.
In August.
Yeah. 2021. Best team performance, Sorba.
I said Stockport away.
Why?
Because Surrey lost to be literally in the first 20 minutes, we literally blew them away. It was like 4-0 up in that 20 minutes, like, and I think everything around it, going forward, defending, I thought they couldn't literally get near us. Other than like the first couple of minutes in the second half, other than that, they couldn't really get near us.
Steve-O, any advances on that?
I wasn't there, but obviously I watched the game. And yeah, like, because I was there in the meeting before the game or pre-match meeting, and I think everything played out. So
then, okay, because you wasn't involved in it or witnessed it firsthand, what would you say your best team performance was?
Probably Yeovil, because it was at, not a, like a proper turning point, but it was kind of a turning point because we go there, like everyone expects Yeovil to beat us. I think they're like second or third in the league at that time. And I think we was under the cosh first, probably most of the first half. I think Woody went off. I don't know, maybe a couple of other substitutions, but second half, like, I think we blew them away.
I think
I just thought, like, that's when I thought this team, like, we could do something.
Fair point. I said it in my Q&A. What was fundamentally the turning point for the season? I think the chairman alluded to it. There was a conversation between myself and the chairman, played a massive part in that. I think Sorba going from that central role, and you've done fantastic, Sorb, to the, that's your natural position, isn't it? People fear you in that natural position down that left-hand channel. And I think to have the likes of you and Kane doing that, and Femi gone in at left side centre-half on that day, I thought it plays to his strengths. Yeah, Yeovil. What about Dagenham?
Dagenham
away. You remember when P and Tom Chandler were like, they're everywhere. He keeps saying it. Gero said, didn't he? It's like, you're on a boat. And you find a hole, so you plug it, and another bit of water comes out, and you try and plug that, then you try and plug another hole. It was literally, for 45 minutes, they made two subs in 28 minutes. You don't do that unless you're getting felt. Stockport away, Sorba. It was, for the first time in my career, I've sat on the bench, Cams, isn't it?
Yeah.
I sat there, it was like, wow. Like, every single, Tom Champ pressing. Femi locking in, you doing your drills, say Shabu, that taking that responsibility of having that 1v1 centre of the park, how many times he broke through midfield. I just thought, yeah, he was. I've got three here. I've got Dagenham, but I've underlined Stockport. And as a manager, I've thrown him filed. Do you know why? Because you rolled your sleeves up and went away with a 2-1 win. And I look at them and go, they're big, big points, big, big wins, them. Big wins. And I'm not saying it was a great performance, because I've never played in them conditions. I've played in some bad conditions, not where the corner flags.
They were
horizontal. And it was horrendous to play in. So for me, I have to agree with you, Sorb, Stockport. I don't know if you got any different on that, Cams.
Yeah, I had Stockport. I also had, and I've underlined the word performance, not result, performance. I thought at home to Barrow.
I thought
when you look at what happened away, and I think we can openly say away from home, they were the better side, and they sort of first half they real schooled us. And then you look at the flip side now, our plays, the game plan, everything about the day. I think the team that are flying top of the league, I think in the most respectful way, I think it was the flip side. I think how we didn't come away with a win was criminal to a side that's top of the league.
He ruined it for everyone. Now, I think the performance, you're spot on there, Cams. I thought, and the management of the game from the players, because we had a sort of a mindset of how we would do it. If it ain't working, you have to reconfigure it and you change it. Bumping up that middleman into the centre half. I thought, yeah, performance-wise, I have to say, was very good. Yeah. Hartlepool away. You could probably say there's
Dover.
Both to an extent.
Yeah.
I thought away from home, we blew them away. There's not many, I'd say, on the flip side where you go, didn't deserve much there. I think there's a lot more positives from this season than there was negatives. Hence where we were currently, or where we are currently in division. But
yeah.
Stockport, Yeovil, Barrow,
Solihull,
how good. We forced you lot to play. We'd done two sessions on it, playing out from the back. Do you remember it, Steve? And it was like, literally, no, I don't care. You're going to play.
Yeah.
You're going to play. And how good were we? the little rotation from the midfielders, the wing backs. Where was you asked to stand, Sorbs? Was you playing on the point or was you on the
wing? No, I was on the point.
Yeah. So the wing backs was told to go nice and high. Yeah,
home and away.
Yes, mate. Yeah, I think there was some proper performances this year. I have to say that there were. So I'm going to say Stockport because I think you've hit the nail on the head, Sorbs.
Yeah.
I think to a game plan to go away from home to a team that were fifth at the time, 5,000, 6,000, and to go and hit them for 3-0 before the half commences was superb. But I think we'll all agree there was a lot more positives in the season than a lot more negatives.
Yeah,
100%. Here you go then, Sorbs. You are now what? What are you now, Sorbs? 22? 21. 10 plus 9, 21. You're now what? 49 years on. Your beard slightly grey. Your retirement dinner. Five of your good pals stand up. Each one of them says a quality about you. Fire away.
Well, I've gone with funny, is trouble, argumentative, is a talent, and cocky.
So your five mates,
that's what you want them to say, yeah?
Yeah.
That's what they all say.
Steve-o. Arrogant, cocky. Yeah, he's trouble. He's trouble.
Horrible was person, man.
Was you doing this for time and dinner in prison?
Nah. Of course not.
Listen, I'm gonna hand it over to a little bit slightly more experienced man in Cameron. Now, these are the qualities you'd want to hear.
Okay. Hardworking. I think I'm a hardworking individual. I think they'll say that I'm a loyal person. So when I'm with something or someone and commit something, I'm loyal to it. I'm selfless. I think I would happily sacrifice myself for the improvement of the team or something else. I'm honest. Try and be honest as possible. And I think I'm a family man. So I'd like to be known as a family man. I'd always put my family first and do anything for my family. So they're the five things. Hardworking, loyal, selfless, honest. A family man.
Spot on, mate. I have to agree. I think five good qualities, mate.
I think you can pride yourself on qualities. They're definitely five. I'd like to pride myself on and what I'd like to be remembered for.
Mm-hmm. I would disagree with Sorbas, though, to be fair. I mean, like, his mates ain't wrong. They're not liars. They might be a little... They might not be good mates, but they're not liars. I have to say that.
I thought you meant like in football. Not me as a person. I thought you meant in football. Like, what
okay, here you go. Boom. Five qualities as a person, Sorba.
Oh, as a person?
Go on then.
Go on. Well, I didn't really write it down.
No, don't write it down. Just say it, mate. Just say five.
As a person. You're a copy, mate. Yeah, like, I'll say funny as well. I'll also say trouble. I'll say confident.
Yeah.
A sticky one
still.
Anything about your brains?
By my brain?
Yeah.
Nah. Nothing about my brain. Nah, I'll say that then three. I can't think of any other two.
Yeah, don't have five. Why have five when you can have three? You're right. Steve-o, come on in. Hit us, big man. What are we saying?
Probably family man as well. I think that's important. I think hard working because talent don't always get you where you need to get. So, like, never give up. But even when things are going wrong, you just got to keep going.
Yeah.
Times will always come. Loyal. Infectious.
Three of my three so far.
Infectious. Like, people want to be. I would like to think that people want to be around me because I'm a good person to be around.
Lovely one. Nice one.
And trustworthy. Like, people, you know, you can trust me.
Spot on, Steve-O.
They're five good ones.
They're five great ones, mate. Five great ones. Mine are funny, caring, generous, honest, and loyal. There's my five. So we've all touched on some.
Yeah.
I would say trouble, Sorba.
Talent.
What about my brain? Nothing about my brain. I think you've had three very good qualities, Sorba.
Thank you.
Really good, mate. Here you go, then. This is a good one. This is a good one. You're stuck on a desert island. You can take one item and one member of the squad. Playing squad, guys. Footballers. Yes. Not staff, footballers. So I know you take.
You me?
Footballers. So who you got? What's your one item? And what's your one player you're taking?
I read the question wrong. So that would be some famous people. But in the squad, has to be champ. Has to be. Because he would just make
do your laugh. Celebration. Do your celebration. What do you do with him?
Yeah! Yeah! it's a champ because it just makes me laugh. Like, anything he does, it just makes me laugh. And then I say I'm football so we can play two touch.
That's very you.
What you want to know? Just so I'm clear on this, Cams. We're on a desert island, yeah? You're on a desert island. You've probably got 3 days max. 3 days max to survive.
And it's roasting.
Yep, and it's roasting. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take a Jacko ball. No. Champ, that will save us. We'll eat the leather. When it comes to the balloon inside, and we'll chew it. Seriously. Cans, what are you saying, mate?
I've got a boat. I'm taking a boat because I can get off whenever I want to get off. And Nathan Ashmore, I think he would keep it entertaining. He reminds me of, what's the film? The cartoon. The little Samoan cartoon character.
Timon and Pumba.
Yeah.
No.
What?
Who?
No.
Like the long one and then the big stocky one.
Mawer?
Oh, not Timon and Pumba. I honestly thought you were Timon and Pumba. That's lying. I thought you used the little stocky one and he's Timon or whatever it is.
It's Mona and Mawer or something like that?
Moana.
Moana, yeah. He reminds me of that. So,
what, him, the big geezer with all the tattoos?
Yeah.
What, he parts the waves?
Yeah.
We need to grow up.
We're out.
He's got a Jacko ball and you're taking Moana.
Too much child TV, I think that he's had the last couple of weeks. But yeah, I've got a boat in Ashmore because Ashmore would entertain you, wouldn't he? I was going to say Ashmore and Keg of Jaeger because I think he'd liven it up, but we wouldn't survive. Man,
3 minutes. Then what are you doing?
That ain't lasted.
Cam, so what? So what I've put down then, so I'm saying, I want a hotel then. I want a hotel. I mean, fully furnished hotel.
That's not an item.
No, it's a boat, is it?
Yeah,
we've just got a wooden boat.
Yeah,
a boat's a vehicle.
So then how are you paddling the boat then? Because one item, how are you paddling the boat? How are you paddling the boat?
The boat. We've got a motor on the back.
Oh, so it's a boat and it's got a motor.
Yeah, Steve, we got our question marks on this, mate.
What's it got? Bottles of water on it as well.
Yeah. Steve, who are you taking?
A car's an item, though. So you've got a car.
But... It's a silly thing to suggest, isn't it? I want to take a cruise liner. I want to take a cruise liner. There we go. I want to take a cruise liner. P&O.
That's your pick.
I thought we'd been a little bit more adventurous. Sorba's obviously gone football because he loves football. But other than that, Steve, what are you going for, mate? Try and bring this a little bit more realistic.
I know. Well, it'd be a bit like being in prison, wouldn't it? So I'll probably take Kane because I've seen him in his Barbie outfit. With them tight things, so I'll probably take him. Sorry, Sorbs.
No worries, mate.
You don't like that kind of talk, do you?
No worries, mate.
I'd have to take a knife or something. Like,
what, to cut him up?
To cut him up?
Nah, it was great. Kind of, like, to make
eat him.
To make, go hunt like, him.
To hunt. To hunt.
Yeah, to hunt, yeah. So good. Kane for a bit of eye candy, and then a knife for, yeah.
I've seen him. Hey, they will need to get that picture for this, because he looks cute in that Barbie outfit, doesn't he?
He does.
Would you get him holding your pocket like tea bag on prison?
Yeah.
Pull the pocket. Like, put it out, and he's got to walk with you.
Yeah, hold that.
Now I get Steve. I totally get where you're coming from. The geezer wants the cruise liner. You're getting yourself Barbie. Very smart. Mine's champ, mate. Morale's so low. And yeah, I just need him to just, you know, like the sweaty Lee Evans he is and this sort of mannerism. I need him to like bring me up a level. And the next one, because I would have bought a hotel fully furnished, is a water purifier.
That's clever. Very practical.
We're covered, but we're surrounded by water. Purify it, drink it.
In the hotel?
No, not in a hotel, but I just think it's quite smart. So who's just walked into your room, Sorbs?
What's that?
Who's walked into your room?
No, my sister.
He's got a lunch brought to him.
He has. Just been fed. So now, obviously, what it is now is we're going to go quick fire round. Three questions. Has everyone got their three questions? So,
come on, it's yours.
Am I saying the first question, then the next one, then the next one, then the answer?
No. So, how it would work, you'd say a question and you'd wait for an answer. if you could answer it and wait until Cameron would answer. That's fantastic, pal.
Question number one, Cameron. Would you rather the last 20 pictures in your camera roll made public or your last 20 messages? Question mark.
I'll have the last 20 pictures.
Slippery you, mate.
Oh,
how slippery are you?
Could be both. I'm not pleased with both.
Eric the eel, look at him. Eric.
I'm easy with both.
Oh, he's gone from pictures to both now.
Eric the eel.
You'd be very bored. There'd be a lot of pace boys being text.
So you've gone pictures, yeah?
Yeah, pictures, I'll say.
All right. Question number two. Would you rather say I love you to everyone when you hang up the phone or accidentally call your significant other by your ex's name during a fight?
Oh, I say I love you to everyone I speak to on the phone. No chance. You loser, Ed.
Yeah.
No,
Steve, if you want to get your picture back up, mate.
Sorry.
That's a no-brainer, Sorba.
Yes. The second one will be a bit sticky, Cam, not gonna lie.
Yes, a little bit sticky, soft, as you say.
And the last one, would you rather bark like a dog when you feel threatened or blow up like a pufferfish?
Bark like a dog. I don't know. Because obviously, bark like a dog when I feel threatened, I think. I think I wouldn't feel threatened. Good questions. Good questions.
Thank you, Kev.
That's a difficult one. All right. Steve-O, you ready?
Yeah.
Would you rather a unibrow or a full back of hair?
There's a kit man in the National League that's got it in it. He's got business at the front, party at the back, isn't he?
Yeah, he has.
You've seen him. He's like, business, party! Yeah? So what are we saying? No hair. And then, like, party at the back or like a full-on fro?
No, you mean
a unibrow? No,
monobrow. Monobrow, yeah. Yeah. And then, like, long hair at the back, you said, right?
No. Full back of hair. So,
on the back. Sorry.
Yeah, on the back.
Back of hair. Apologies.
Yeah.
Good memory. I like that.
We've got to get that picture up.
For the full back of hair, you can cover that up, can't you?
Yeah, you can. Then we go to the beach, though, in Marbella.
Yeah, this is it, mate. I've got to be honest. You got to pick and choose. You're 12 months. It? You're 12. No. 12 months, you're on show. Yeah. 2 months, you look like you got a V-neck on.
Constant.
Yeah.
So you got back of hair, yeah?
Yeah.
Any hair for Steve, I would be...
He'd be trying to transfer it.
You'd comb it up.
I'm going back of hair, yeah.
All right, cool. Question two. Would you rather be an unknown superhero or a famous villain?
That's a great question.
It's a terrific question. I didn't think of it. I'll take the credit.
I think I'd be an unknown superhero.
Would you?
Yeah.
Like it. So you like to be unknown.
You get a lot of self-worth out of that, wouldn't you?
good answer.
No, nice. But then, yeah. So you'd only really know yourself, though. Are you content with that?
Yeah, that's fine.
It's nice. That's why you had the five qualities from the retirement dinner. You're a top guy.
Lovely guy. All right. Question number three: would you like to only be able to whisper, or to be able to shout?
Hello.
Ah. It'd be awkward if you're in like a library or like a church or something, you could only shout.
You got to pick your environment, Steve. Oh, surely. You can't be walking around.
No, but then if you was on a football pitch and you could only whisper.
Yeah.
I played with a few like that. But...
Hey, some of them, they made love when they played, didn't they?
That mute.
Man, I'll have to go shout. I'd rather shout.
That's aggressive, though, isn't it?
Yeah. Hello, how are you?
Steve-o, good round. What you got for me, mate? You can't keep coming off the camera, though, Steve-o.
Sorry, I've got one more from Cam's, haven't I?
That's free.
Just free.
You're struggling with numbers today, Dave. You've gone 6,005 aside. You've asked for four questions and a free question.
The lockdown.
I appreciate it, mate. That jump is too tight around your neck.
Would you rather have a paper cut every time you pick up a piece of paper, or bite your tongue every time you eat?
All right, no brainer. Bite my tongue. Pick a paper cut. All day long, I just want to pick up paper.
Yeah, you need to eat, really, don't you?
Listen, you could... Yeah, you probably struggle 3 days, 4 days without eating. Yeah. And then, yeah.
Yeah, it's a no-brainer, that one, isn't it? Silly. What about... Would you rather take the flak for a murder you committed, or let your mate or let your best friend take the flak for the murder?
So I've committed a murder.
Yeah. Would you rather own up, do the time, or would you rather let your mate do the time?
No, I couldn't let my mate do the time.
That's bad, isn't it?
Yeah, I've got to be honest. If I've done it, I have to own it. Yeah. I have to own it. I couldn't, yeah. Snitches get stitches. And if I go to prison and I've got pink yoga pants on and you're there, I'll be holding your pocket.
It's over it.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, no, I agree with that one. The last one, would you rather have if you have BO all the time and not know it's you, or constantly smell a bad smell all the time, but you're the only one who can smell it?
Nah, constantly smell a bad smell.
You'd rather that?
Yeah.
Rather than having BO, but not...
So I've got BO and everyone can smell it?
Yeah.
Nah.
No, I agree with that.
I'd rather smell a bad smell. I couldn't... Nah, I can't... If I'm walking into a gaff and I stink up the gaff with BO, nah. When everyone goes, here's the geezer here. It's B.O. boy. Walking in every time. I can't, that, Steve, I can't have that, mate.
That's really selfless.
No, thank
you,
mate.
That's like you, Cam, selfless.
Yeah.
Cheers, Steve. What a nice set of guys we are.
Yeah.
This
one's going to be comedy gold now, Sorba. I think you might struggle on a few of these. Would you rather stub your toe once a day, or lose a finger of your choice?
I think I'd rather stub my toe.
Have you done it? Have you done it properly, though? Like, stubbed your toe properly?
Well, I haven't really stubbed my toe in a while.
No, but okay, you're going to be doing it every day. You know the ones where you go into the table or the corner of a door. Oh my lord!
Women, yeah, but it only hurts for a few seconds.
Stubbing your toe is horrendous.
Yeah, but it only hurts for a few seconds, and then it's gone.
Yeah, listen, I'd rather keep all my fingers, so I have to agree with you on that. But stubbing your toe, I'm talking, is horrendous. Which is fair. Would you rather be in jail for 5 years or in a coma for 5 years?
No brainer.
Yeah, I feel I'd rather be in a coma, you know, because jail, when you've got people like Steve, I wouldn't want to be with them.
But you're losing out. So in jail, you get a phone call. I mean, so you can see and speak to loved ones. I know it's horrible behind the screen. I get that, but
in a coma, it's like someone's just pressed pause, isn't it? You wake up.
Yeah. 5 years older, obviously, but yeah effectively, yeah. You're not seeing or hearing. You might hear from them, granted, but you're not seeing and talking and communicating with your loved ones. It's a tough one, isn't it? You jump straight in coma. You're flat coma, yeah?
I don't ever want to go to jail. Like, when I see some documentaries, I don't ever want to be there. So I'll
that's fair, mate. We'll stop being troubled then. Would you rather have 3 nipples or 11 toes?
What do you mean, like, 3 there and then 3 there?
Just 3, so
that's 6, mate.
this mouse thing's been tough today.
We got to do number blocks, lads. Yeah. Some of us in our mouse are struggling.
Wait, 3 nipples or 10?
So you've currently got 2 nipples, I believe. Everyone's got a nipple sword, 2 nipple swords. Then just put a middle one. Here's your bag. that or 11 toes.
So basically, an extra toe.
Yeah, you got 10 at the moment.
Yeah, so it's just an extra toe. Oh.
But it's got to be a big toe on the side of your foot on a right angle.
I'll say, but then holidays, man, isn't it?
Then what, matey?
I was going to say 3 nipples, but then that, you know, when you go on holiday and you got to take your top off and it's got bang, 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 like, nah.
But then, what, are you walking around with Tim's then on holiday? you got flip-flops on? Surely you got flip-flops on and the toes there as well. And everyone's going, why have you got a toe on your foot that's on a right angle?
I'm going to have to go with the 3 nipples. I'm going to go with 3 nipples. Then I'll just wear a vest.
Yeah, smart. Nice. And then what if it gets slightly cold and you got 3 red things here? It's slightly hard. Sorry, so what's that in the middle of your chest? Nothing.
Yeah, I'm going to go with my answer. 3 nipples.
I believe we got a bonus round as well, Cam.
Yeah, I'm going to ask. So we'll put it to everybody, okay? So, last question. Would you rather, this football go first to Steve-O. Would you rather the ability to fly or the ability to be invisible?
Well, then, whoa. I will answer this for him. I know if you lie, I know full well what you're doing. You don't care about flying, Steve-O. I know exactly what you're doing with your invincibility as well. It ain't even allowed to go on screen.
Yeah, get me that invisibility cloak.
And it wears out and you're in the middle of it. Sorry, guys. I was supposed to be in it. Yeah.
Invisible, yeah.
Definitely. Gaffer, to you?
Yeah. Invisible for probably different reasons to speak of. Just an earwig, innit? Just have a little earwig, see what they're saying about you. Because I can imagine people hate me. It'd be nice just to hear what they say. Flying's great, mate. Am I talking, have you got, like, speed with it? Or it's just fly? Flying could be good, then. Imagine that. Straight across as a crow flies. Yeah, I'm going to argue the opposite to Steve-O. What's that, matey?
Get boring after a while, wouldn't it, flying?
Yeah, because you can't. Like, walking. Can't get bored being invisible, can you?
Go on, Sobs. What would you do?
I want to be invisible, Cap.
What would you use your power on, Sorba? Just out of interest.
Do you know what it is? I will rob banks. I will all the people that annoy me, I'll go to their house, I will slap them, they won't be able to see me. Like, I'll do badness.
You just sitting in your room. You're going. Smacking his head.
Sure.
Quite, Sorba, you're a hero.
I
are
would...
you getting in the house? You're knocking on the door. Knocking on the door. Talk us through what you do.
So, like, I don't know, like, if I told my sister to, like, make me dinner, and she said no, and she swore at me, I'd be like, put a cloak on, go in the room, bang.
Gosh.
Straight head across her face.
You gotta hit your sister.
And then she's looking around, thinking, who's at me? Then I'll give her another one.
You know, 4 minutes earlier, you went, I don't ever want to go to prison. Within 10 seconds of getting invisibility, I'm robbing a bank. Sorba, you're a hero. You're a hero. Kaz, what are you saying?
I'd want to fly because yeah. I do a lot of journeys. A lot of journeys. And I've got to be honest with
you. You do.
Traffic's my biggest bugbear. So get a fly from home to work to barrow away would be amazing without having to sit in traffic. So I'm going to be boring. And I'll fly. People are going to say stuff about me anyway. I don't really care. So definitely the flying one. Definitely.
You obviously wouldn't get on the bus for the players to barrow them. You just fly with them.
Just fly straight there.
Where's Cams? Actually, he's by the side of the coach on the M1.
And we meet you up there, yeah?
Yeah, Cams, you do what you want to do, mate. You get yourself out there quick and back quick. Yeah, no problem.
Yeah,
boys, I have to say, thoroughly enjoyed this show. Thoroughly enjoyed it. Some great content. Thank you very, very much for joining us on Coach's Corner. You've just been watching episode 4 of Coach's Corner.
Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it.
Follow us on Instagram and Twitter.
Like and subscribe our YouTube channel.